They had fashion on their minds as they entered the building. Soon, the only thing the Spurs will be thinking about is a win here at home. And the game arrival, sponsored by Express. Dress like a pro. Downtown San Antonio, Texas. This bridge spans the Riverwalk, not too far from our location tonight. Welcome, everyone, to Noche NBA. A Latin theme is the backdrop to tonight's festivities. Tonight, we'll see the San Antonio Spurs as they play against the Dallas Mavericks. Our broadcast team tonight, on one side, Greg Anthony. On the other side, Steve Smith. And on the sideline, David Aldridge. I'm Kevin Harlan. Now we have a moment to look at how the blocks have been stacking up over the past several months for Aldridge.
We're just not seeing that same fierceness out of him defensively these last few months. He's lost a little bit of that intimidation factor. He's not blocking as many shots, and he's not making the same impact on that end of the floor.
Now let's send it down to David Aldridge, standing by from the sidelines. David?
Well, guys, DeMar DeRozan is a prolific scorer, but he's also a dangerous drive and kick weapon. He said, "I never pay attention to the defender guarding me. I look at the four guys behind him and how they react. A lot of times I don't even look to score. I draw three or four guys and get my teammates open shots." Kevin?
Great vision, David. Thank you. Smitty, we have a good rivalry game tonight with two conference foes. This should be a beauty.
Yes, indeed. I think the fans feel it, the coaches feel it. Us as announcers, we feel it. The atmosphere is going to be great.
It is indeed. Now, a look at Dallas's starting lineup. They've got Porzingis. Curry is out there with Luka Doncic. Then there's Hardaway, and it's Finney Smith in at the four. And for San Antonio, they've got DeJounte Murray. Miles out there with DeRozan. Then there's LaMarcus Aldridge, and it's Forbes in at the two spot. Now here is Aldridge. Porzingis with the block. Hardaway against DeRozan. Porzingis can't hit. And it's DeRozan with the ball for San Antonio. Tough loss coming against Cleveland in their last game played.
Yeah, I mean, in that one, you really saw a difference in aggression between the two teams, particularly on the boards.
You know, you can't allow that many second chance opportunities and then get almost none yourself. Rarely that works out for you.
Here's Murray, 17 points for him last game against the Cavaliers in Cleveland.
We also got to mention what he did on the defensive end. Racked up a number of steals, too.
Now here's Murray. Pass to Lyles. Back to Murray. Five to shoot. Goes back up. And that's 2 points on the layup. Murray's got his second basket of the game.
Explosive athleticism. Murray usually showing it with the ball in his hands. But he can also just go get it.
Hardaway finds Curry. Pass to Finney Smith. Launches it, and a great assist by Curry as that one goes in.
And he likes to get in a rhythm early. Nice triple.
Out to the right wing. Aldridge, the pass to Murray. And there it is for him. Murray's got six.
I like the efficiency here. 3 out of 4 shooting, just taking what the defense gives him.
On the wing, Doncic. He's covered by Murray.
So quick off the floor, Murray can afford to wait until the shooter commits.
And he drops in the layup off the glass.
Trying to attack the heart of that defense with great teamwork.
If you're just tuning in, we played about 2.5 minutes here in the first. Doncic passes to Kerr. Dallas moving it around. And the dunk by Doncic.
Has the vertical needed to dunk it. Doncic showing off the power and flair that he possesses.
There's the pass to Murray. The kick out to Aldridge. And it goes out of bounds. Last touch by Murray. You're looking at the list of the NBA's top shooters from behind the arc for the past month. Look at Curry, one of the best shooters in the NBA, top 5 in the league at this moment.
Sometimes a 3-point shooter gets into that rhythm and just keeps carrying it over. That's been the case for him the entire month.
Outside, Porzingis. There's the dish to Hardaway. Here's Doncic. That one doesn't go. And so it's Murray with it. He brings it up for the Spurs. Pass to Forbes. Shot clock at 5. The Spurs need to get a shot off here. Miles, no good.
And when you are as good a shooter as he is, you have the confidence. You have to have the confidence to take that shot. It might not always fall.
You know what another option is? Just give the ball up. Let someone else make a play.
And he's capable of scoring from anywhere, really. Doncic has a strong grasp here of the mid-range.
Outside DeRozan. And contact on the shot, so he'll be shooting free throws here.
It's common to see wing players improve their perimeter shooting in the league, but DeMar DeRozan's most striking growth has been his ball handling and playmaking. He's been dynamic with the ball in his hands.
And he knocks down the first one. And Greg DeRozan watching a ton of films of guys like Andre Miller and Sam Cassell operating in the pick and roll.
Not only that, Kevin, to strengthen his left hand, he'd use it for daily activities like writing, leaving no stone unturned to become an expert initiator.
He's perfect from the line this time.
The ninth pick in 2009, DeRozan was part of a great draft class. Griffin, Harden, and Curry, all included.
Here's Doncic. Another 3 for Dallas.
They're getting him shots in his spots. That's understanding your personnel.
DeRozan against Doncic. And DeRozan throws it down hard.
Incredible leaper, explosive finisher, DeRozan with one of his acrobatic dunks.
Outside Hardaway. Finney-Smith kicks to Porzingis. Passes it to Doncic. From outside, off the mark.
There was a mix-up defensively. Left him all alone. He just couldn't hit it.
Back to DeRozan. Here's Wiles. Shoots over Curry. And another basket for San Antonio.
I like this. I really do. He recognizes the mismatch, simply rises up, and fires.
Porzingis feeling it out a bit. Back to Doncic. Pulls it up. It's hauled in by Lyle.
Missed opportunity wide open from mid-range. He would love to get that one back.
Forbes dishes to DeRozan. Murray against Doncic. And it's Murray penetrating. Nice D from Doncic. For Dallas, they've gotten 5 of 10 shots to drop in this game so far. Right at the 50% mark. Outside, Porzingis. Back to Doncic. Down it goes. That's 4 made from the field. He's 4 of 8.
And certainly not lacking in confidence. When Doncic gets these inside looks, he just jumps all over.
And San Antonio calls the first timeout of the game. Greg, you look at the young Luka Doncic. What impresses you the most right now about his game?
Well, Kevin, you just don't see many players his height who can handle and make step-back threes. Also, his confidence. He came into the league never doubting that he could dominate a game, and don't forget about his brilliance as a passer.
So San Antonio goes with a fresh five on the floor.
And let's check out a breakdown looking at some data for White. His last 10 games, he's putting up about 12 points a game, 3 assists and 3 rebounds. He's been making the right decisions and letting the game come to him. Solid play all around.
He's not trying to take over necessarily. He's just taking what the defense allows and contributing to the calls.
Here's Cauley-Stein after Rudy Gay's bucket. Pass to Barea, fires from deep. The shot missing. Now San Antonio takes it the other way. Walker surveying the floor. The pass to Medu. Spurs working the ball around now. Bellinelli pass it to Gay. Off the mark. His first miss of the game. 1 for 2. White against Kid Gilchrist. Pass to Barea. Here's Kleba. Nothing yet on the scoreboard for him. Let's it go from deep. And that's collected by Gay.
And he didn't punish them for the weak coverage there, but they can't count on him to continue missing.
And it's White missing.
And the pressure he put on that shot forced the miscue.
The rim protection at its finest. The result is the same whether you block the shot or simply change it.
Gay left side. Outside, Walker. Gay, right side. Puts the fadeaway right on the money. Gay's got his second bucket of the game to go.
Good job of stepping up to the plate there, seizing back the momentum for his team.
That's the competitor in him. Close game. Let me have this one.
A little artistry in the painted area, converting against the size.
Proving once again that when you attack with confidence, good things tend to happen.
Now, here's Bellinelli. He's averaging around 5.5 points a game. The Italian Marco Bellinelli, one of the league's best sharpshooters, and Greg, very comfortable shooting on the move.
He always seems to be floating one way or the other on his shot. It wouldn't work for most shooters, but he uses it to evade the D.
Shooting two.
No good on the free throw.
And you look at all the under-the-radar prospects that have found success with the Spurs. How do they keep hitting on all these players other teams have missed?
They do a great job with their player development. They also do a great job identifying players with great character. They have guys who work extremely hard. They have great coaching, and they teach. But more importantly, what they do, GA, they give you confidence. And that's where I think the Spurs separate from other organizations.
Now here's Wright. And looking at his production, he averages a little more than 7 points a game. And foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line. It's going to be on Rudy Gay. The Mavericks shooting their first free throws of the game on this trip to the line.
And I think this is a strength of this team. Solid numbers at the line across the board, 77% collectively.
And they now lead as the free throw drops for him. And so Wright nails both of them. 1:02 left to play here in the first. Wright finds Bellinelli. Back to White. Passes it to Gay. 6 on the shot clock. Walker with a clean look. Again, the miss by the Spurs.
And Kevin, they need to be consistent with their effort on the boards. You look at the box score, and they're at a definite disadvantage.
The Mavericks have gone 2-for-2 in the game at the line. First free throw is good. Mills, he's checked in for San Antonio. That misses, so he splits the free throws.
In a funk this quarter, he's trying to shoot his way out of it.
23 seconds left in the first quarter. Kicks it to Bellinelli. They get the rebound. It's good. And that's now 6 points for Gay. Barea with it. And that would have counted, but his shot was off the mark this time. So at the end of one quarter of play, still a close game. The Mavericks on top, up one. Live from the AT&T Center in San Antonio, you're watching 2K Sports. And in 2018, DeMar DeRozan opened up about his battles with depression, hoping to have a positive impact on others.
The people shame to talk about it. Even myself, for a long period of time, people wonder why I was such a quiet guy. And that was part of it, not wanting to speak out about it, not wanting other people to know exactly what I was going through. But you get to a certain age where you feel like it's all about helping others. It's not about you just being a selfish person about the things you're going through, other people going through stuff as well.
Yep, you love the honesty and the bravery to step forward and tell his emotional story.
Yeah, he opened a dialogue, Kevin Love following his lead to talk about anxiety. Athletes as public figures can have a broader impact than just entertaining, and we see it over and over again.
And we welcome you back to our special Noche Latina broadcast. As the second quarter getting going right now. And guys, what's your take so far on the Mavs?
Showing a lot of confidence in their rotation. They went right to that bench when they needed points.
This is where you credit the guys in the front office for going out and getting you the pieces you need.
All fueled up and ready to go. Let's reset the lineups courtesy of Gatorade as the second quarter gets going. On the floor for Dallas, we've got Michael Kidd-Gilchrist. J.J. Barea is out there with Wright. Then it's Willie Cauley-Stein. And it's Kleba in at the four slot. And both free throws good from Michael Kidd-Gilchrist. So Steve, the league has done a pretty good job of curbing player altercations. So some guys, always, though, it seems, are going to be ready to go toe-to-toe and will not back down.
Patrick Beverly, Kevin, Draymond Green, right. James Johnson, yeah. Those guys come to mind. They are ready to go from the tip. They are ready to go.
Here's Wright. Misses the layup.
He liked to have that one back. That's easy money.
Gay passes to Mills. And we're about a minute into the second quarter of play. Just 5 on the clock. Rudy Gay on the wing. Pulls up from the corner. Second shot opportunity. And it's blocked. Barea against Bellinelli. Got a piece of it. And here's Mills. He's been quiet so far. Still no points in the game. Gay dishes to Mills. Oh, to Bellinelli. Lets the three fly, and no good. And it's Dallas the other way. They'll host the Denver Nuggets after this one. That game marks the first half of a quick two-game homestand. Now here's Barea. Here's Kidd Gilchrist. He hits the back iron and sinks the shot. Kidd Gilchrist has got the lead up to five now for Dallas. On the pass to Medu. Gay against Cauley Stein.
Some players never recover from a torn Achilles. Rudy Gay has come back and as good as ever, still one of the most productive small forwards we have in the league.
He's getting his first free throw attempt of the night right now.
Shooting two.
First one falls for him.
A really solid shooter once he gets to the line, and Rudy Gay has gotten to the line a lot in his career.
Here's what San Antonio's going with right now. LaMarcus Aldridge has checked in for Medu. DeRozan comes in for Marco Bellinelli. And it's Bryn Forbes in for White. Rudy Gay hits them both.
We've seen him put a lot of pressure on the defense and then cash in at the line.
Outside Hardaway. And the whistle blows on the backcourt violation. He went over and back. And here's a look at some numbers for Doncic.
And he's gone dry over the past 10 games, guys. His scoring is way down, and he can't seem to fight his way out of the slump. He better get it going tonight, or they'll start losing patience with him.
To the paint. And the shot is good. The Maverick lead has been cut down to just one on the basket from Forbes.
Perfect vision. Mills getting quicker these days at spotting the open man.
Doncic passes to Hardaway. Dallas moving the ball around. Porzingis can't hit. And so it's Mills who will bring it up for the San Antonio Spurs. Feeds it to Aldridge. An easy 2 points on the layup. And the Spurs lead by one.
They are just killing them on the interior.
Doncic kicks to Hardaway. From 13. And yes, it's good. Hardaway has got his second basket. Well, guys, this first half has been about as tightly contested as you could hope for.
There have been a lot of lead changes.
Goodness. Now let's go to the sideline and catch up with our Hall of Famer, David Aldridge.
Well, Kevin, my cousin LaMarcus Aldridge is not the flashiest player, but he is respected. His former teammate in Portland, C.J. McCollum, said he hasn't changed his game to try and fit the new NBA. He shoots mid-range, scores under the basket, strong as heck. He knows who he is. And Kevin, LaMarcus isn't really my cousin, but his game never goes out of style.
You're right, D.A., and he is still getting it done. Thank you. Mills can't hit.
He is so good attacking the rim. It's rare to see him denied like that.
Curry can't get it to go. San Antonio leading. Now Mills. He provides a good amount of offense for the team, averaging around 11.5 points a game. For Dallas, they've gone just 2 of 8 shooting here in the second quarter. Curry. Some solid defense from Aldridge. Spurs have gone just 33% from the field in what's been a cold second quarter for them. Just 3 of 9. Dishes to Mills. Chalk up two there. Mills has got the lead up to three now for San Antonio.
And not hard to see why they are giving up points on this run. Just too many good looks from in close.
Doncic passes to Porzingis, and the dunk by Porzingis.
And how about the vision there from Doncic? Can make the easy pass and also the difficult.
Mills looking it over. Pass to Forbes. Gay outside, passes it to DeRozan. Over Hardaway. And closing the shot, even with the foul. Now the two free throws. Tim Hardaway picks one up.
A sneaky move by DeRozan catches the defender leaning and draws the foul.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
The first one falls. Well, Smitty, we're coming down the stretch here. Talk about the mental toughness needed to finish a season strong.
You know, I think you got to have that. Everybody talk about the game physically, guys making shots. And we all know there's some teams and players, they all do that well. But who's the tough team that can get through the tough times? That's when you see the teams that can get over the hump and you start to say, I like that team.
And last season, DeMar DeRozan averaging the lowest rate of three-point attempts of his career.
Kevin, the Raptors had wanted him to shoot more triples. The Spurs were content to put the ball in his hands and let others provide the spacing. This is basketball 101. This is the size mismatch you look to create.
Pass to Murray. Down low. That's basket number two with his third shot off to a fast 2-for-3.
I mean, that's a nice find by Murray. He has a height to see the floor, and his awareness continues to grow.
Here's Hardaway. He had a 30-point outing their last game against Indiana. The pass to Porzingis. Puts it up. And they'll get another chance. Hardaway, no good.
Something that's kept this game close is the fact that the rebound stats for both teams are almost identical. And it just seems that every pass they make is leading to a score. Just great ball movement.
Now, here's Doncic. He's got 9. The shot's good.
Creative at finding ways to just cut inside there. Doncic, a guy you must keep your eyes on.
Here's Aldridge. Over Porzingis. And that one hits back iron.
Once he gets the ball there, you expect him to capitalize. That was a missed opportunity.
And Doncic gets it to go.
And it just seems when Doncic turns it on, it's a sight to see. Incredible at scoring in a variety of ways.
Now here is Aldridge. Scoring-wise, he's definitely making his mark. Right now, he's averaging about 19 points a game. Walker, the pass to DeRozan. Offline with his 3. And so it's Doncic with it. He brings it up for the Dallas Mavericks. Defeated by the Pacers in their last game, they'll try to put that one behind them.
Well, what did them in was all the missed free throws. It could have been a much different outcome.
You hate to lose it at the line, especially when you're getting what you want in other areas of the game.
So it's the Spurs now. San Antonio's gone 0-3 from beyond the arc to start the second quarter. Doncic against Murray. Pass to DeRozan. Over Hardaway. And DeMar DeRozan the bucket on the assist by Murray. That's now 8 points for DeMar DeRozan. Mavericks trail by 3. Doncic passes to Porzingis. Outside Hardaway. Here's Doncic, and another basket for Dallas.
And boy, he's really in a groove. Dominant performance last game. Same thing this time out.
Here's the thing. He's a guy who will go on hot streaks for you over a number of games. I'll tell you what, I think he thought that was going in. I sure did.
From down in the low post, it goes. Doncic has got 17 now.
Shooting at a high clip. He's found ways to get quality looks.
Murray, the pass to DeRozan. Porzingis with the steal. Hardaway against DeRozan. Now here's Curry. Tight defense on him. Here's Walker. It's rebounded by Dallas. 8-second difference between the shot clock and the game clock. Curry kicks to Hardaway. A 3-pointer off the mark. San Antonio trailing here. Murray with it. 6 points for him.
And it's just encouraging to see Luka step up on defense. Must continue to bring that type of intensity.
It's been all about Luka Doncic for the Dallas Mavericks. He notched 8 points in the quarter and has that terrific basketball instinct on display. Back right after this.
It's the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hello, basketball fans. What a pleasure it is to bring you into the 2K studios again. Ernie Johnson, Shaquille O'Neal, Kenny the Jet Smith. Luka Doncic has been the story in this one. He ended up with 17 points, 5 rebounds, and 1 assist. He's in a crazy zone right now and seems to be even hotter than he was in their last game. And Kenny, what are your thoughts on how Dallas played?
I was surprised at how comfortable they seemed here on the road. The hostile crowd, that didn't bother them at all. And I want to see if they can keep that up in the second half.
Shaq, let's get your thoughts on San Antonio.
They played some solid team basketball, Ernie. Pretty good. They were sharing the ball. We saw some nice feeds, a lot of movement. It wasn't 5 individuals out there. It was 1 cohesive unit. And they got the assist to show for it. Their rhythm was nice.
And that's all we have for now. Tell the folks goodbye, Shaq. Tell the folks goodbye,
goodbye.
Kenny. Goodbye. Go to Kevin Harlan.
And after a fairly even first couple of quarters, the second half could turn out to be a great one as both teams try to gain an edge. You know, Luka Doncic has been exceptional here, guys.
Well, we'll find out if they were able to find an answer for him over the break. He was scoring with ease in that first half.
I think both sides probably adjusted a few things. The key for him is to bring the same level of energy over these last two quarters.
And we're halfway through this one. Plenty of basketball left in a game that's been fairly even so far. DeRozan out there with Trey Lyles. Then there's Murray. Then there's LaMarcus Aldridge. And it's Forbes in at the two guard. So that's who Greg Popovich starts the second half with. Down to 5 on the shot clock. Dallas needs to get off a shot. Hardaway, no good.
And the great shooters know when they've got enough opening to go for the 3. I didn't think it was a bad choice on that possession.
Here's Murray. He dishes it to Aldridge. Murray against Doncic. Murray the pass to Lyles. And the dunk by Lyles.
Love Murray's scoring potential, but the development of his playmaking may be in an even higher priority.
Doubled by Murray and stolen by Murray. And the Spurs pushing it up now. DeRozan leading the charge.
And really keeping the ball hopping around here offensively.
Second half of basketball, just over a minute played so far. Passes to Finney-Smith. Al Porzingis. Outside Curry. Just 5 to shoot. Pass to Doncic. From deep. It's hauled in by LaMarcus Aldridge.
And you could tell he thought he had a little more space, but the defender was right there.
The ability to close out on perimeter shooters is so important in today's game.
Just a little over 90 seconds gone in the third quarter. Murray against Doncic. And he's fouled pretty hard on that shot, but he's got the chance to pick up the points at the line.
No, he's standing 6'11 with a 7'5 wingspan. LaMarcus Aldridge prefers playing power forward, but make no mistake, he has the size to hang with the big dogs at center.
And the first one drops. And with his height and reach, not many that can block Aldridge's turnaround jumper.
His release on his jump shot is so high, the rainbow arc It's a beautiful thing to watch.
That one falls, so he hits both of them.
Because he knows he makes a living at the line, he invites contact and sometimes even initiates it.
Doncic kicks to Hardaway. The feed to Curry. And it's sent back by Aldridge.
I mean, showing great anticipation. Aldridge was all over that shot.
Into the third we go. 2 minutes in now. No one near Curry as he lets it go.
That's a big donut, folks, here. Start the second half. Four straight they've missed.
Count that one. Murray's got the lead up to seven now for San Antonio.
They're doing a really good job of getting the ball inside and attacking the paint. That's an area they have completely dominated.
Now here's Porzingis. With an average of around 19 and a half points a game, his scoring has been a constant for them. Back to Curry. Lock at six. Here's Doncic. And that time, also a missed shot.
And battling hard on the glass, they hold the advantage here so far. As the lead continues to grow, this is just heady, sound basketball.
They have just nailed their halftime adjustments. That's for sure. They don't want to have to sweat this one out. They're looking to pull away.
And Dallas calls their first timeout of the game. And every so often, Steve, we'll see two teammates fighting over a rebound. You ever have a teammate upset with you for stealing his rebound?
A lot, Kevin. All the bigs I played with, those guys hated when guards came in. They would elbow you, and if you're on your same team, saying get out of here, especially for a lot of those bigs, it was a lot of rebound incentives in their contract, so they wanted to grab every rebound.
So San Antonio going with an almost entirely new group here. Madu, he's checked in for Aldridge. Gay comes in for Lyles. Bellinelli, he's checked in for DeMar DeRozan. And Derek White subbed in for DeJounte Murray. J.J. Barea has checked in for the Mavericks. Now here's Gay. They lead by their biggest margin of the game, 9. The pass to Bellinelli. Off target there, that would have pushed the lead to double digits.
But only the first miss of the second half. They've come out here with authority.
To the inside, Porzingis to stop the run. It's hauled in by Gay. Gay's got 6 rebounds now in the game.
I can see he's pressing a little now, trying desperately to help them shrink this deficit.
They get a hand on it, and that'll be San Antonio as it goes out of bounds. Spurs retain possession. And the Spurs making a change here. Mills has checked in. White dishes to Mills. Clock at 4. Gets the 3-pointer to fall. White's got himself going there. His first points of the game on the deep ball. And so it's Barea with it. He'll bring it up for the Dallas Mavericks. Nothing yet for them in the third quarter. Inside. And the dunk by Doncic.
And with a strong finish, he finally ends that 13-0 run by San Antonio.
Mills passes to Medu. And that's a foul called on J.J. Barea. That's his first foul.
And now only one away from being in the penalty.
Dallas making a switch here. Kleba's checked in. Mavericks on D. And here's Mills. And the Spurs scoring again.
Defensively, you play Mills to set up from range. So he sneaks inside the arc and does damage.
Now, here's Doncic. 19 points in the game. Here's Porzingis. Good. And the assist goes to Doncic. Porzingis has got 6 points.
I mean, every time down the floor, this is what you're trying to do. Find the right matchup.
Pass to Gay. Got a piece of it. Out of bounds, Dallas will take possession. And a look now at the San Antonio Spurs' upcoming schedule. On Friday, they'll be taking on Paul Millsap and the Denver Nuggets. And then on Saturday, they'll take on Karl Anthony Towns and the Minnesota Timberwolves.
And for that matchup against the Grizzlies, they won't have much room for error in that one. A team like this will punish mistakes, but I could see them walking away with this one.
Now, here's Doncic. He's averaging just around 28.5 points a game. So many offensive skills in his toolkit. A nice shot by Barea.
And you're asking for more trouble than you can handle if you're going to let him just roam free from beyond the arc.
Mills finds Gay. And finished off by Gay.
Well, when they give him the lane, Rudy Gay loves to create off the dribble in these situations.
Doncic outside from deep three-point range. Rebound San Antonio. Meadows got his fourth rebound with that last one here tonight.
He has gone ice cold this quarter, obviously not helping their cause.
Injuries pressing Derek White into a much bigger role in year two. Yeah, but you know what, Smitty? He rose to the occasion.
You know, I love him. He has great size, a 6'4 for a point guard. Good instincts. He can shoot. He can create. I love his versatility.
That one is off. You know, Smitty, NBA referees officials now have a presence on social media that's aiming at educating fans on calls and why they're made.
Yes, and I love it, Kevin, if you have these demos and talk about plays and games and situations that you're educating fans. It's just that fans look at it when these referees, who are human, miss calls, and then they want to re-show these plays that they missed. We still got to understand they're human and they're going to miss some calls.
Well said, Steve. Here's Kleba. He's gotten some minutes, but nothing on the board yet.
And that pick takes the D totally out of the equation.
Hey, if you're not going to fight over, you're essentially giving the shooter the look he wants.
Now here's White. Passes it to Bellinelli. Five on the clock. Outside, Walker takes the three. It's rebounded by Dallas. Kidd Gilchrist looking around. To the left side wing. And he lobs it up toward the rim.
Yeah, nice silky finish on the alley-oop from the stupendous feed.
That sequence couldn't have been executed any better. Barea against White. To the middle. Here's Medi. And that'll be two free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul.
And you don't ever want to get into the habit of letting the offense get to the rim.
This is his first free throw of the game.
And he's shooting his free throws to the tune of 75% this season. Fairly standard numbers.
He misses the free throw. DeMar DeRozan. He's checked in for Bellinelli. And he sinks the second. Now Barea. 9 points in the game so far. Cauley Stein kicks to Kleba. Pass to Barea. Props in the layup for two. Barea's got 11 points.
What a turnaround for him since the half. More aggressive and more effective.
Outside, White. Gay inside, working on Cauley Stein. And here are some players that you want on the line as often as possible these days. For the past month, these are the leading free throw shooting two guards in the league. Derek White is second.
And this is a set of players that can drive and slash, hoping to draw contact, because if they can get to the bucket and the foul, it's going to be a three-point play the hard way.
Give them all credit for the work they put in to become such great free throw shooters. Trust me, it takes a lot of work to shoot those kinds of percentages.
LaMarcus Aldridge, he's checked in for San Antonio. He's off on the second. Since taking over the starting role in 2018, Willie Cauley-Stein lived up to his draft spot of being number six, Greg, overall in 2015.
And you knew that a big man like Cauley-Stein would take a few years to develop, but at a legit 7 feet and great length, he is everything you could hope for in a starting center. Yeah, three consecutive field goals have come right at the rim. The D had better start buckling now.
To the paint, here's Aldridge. And there's the whistle, 3 second violation.
Looking now at the numbers for Wright. How last month turned out for him, he's putting up 6 points a night, 3 assists and 4 rebounds. Nothing about his numbers really jump out at you, but he'll come up with a timely play or two every game.
He understands his role, he accepts it. He's one of those guys who doesn't need the ball to be effective.
Back to Berea. 6 to shoot. Pulls it from 20. Walker with the rebound.
High percentage look for him. But bottom line, they're not all going to go down.
He might not have the long range ability of some other guys, but he will knock down open ones like that.
Now here's Berea. He's got 11. Down low, Cauley Stein. And it's sent back by Aldridge. And they get it back. Here's Kleba. No stopping him there. Jams it in as he's fouled. Chance now for a 3-point play. That's on LaMarcus Aldridge. For Dallas, they have shot 5 of 6 at the foul line tonight. Trey Lyles checked in for San Antonio. DeJounte Murray comes in for White. The Mavericks also with a sub. Curry's checked in for J.J. Barea. What's up? Here's Murray. He's got 8.
And a 2-for-1 is there for him if they want it.
Often the way you end quarters has a big impact on the outcome of the game.
Now here's Walker. 3-point lead. Here's Aldridge. Cauley Stein grabs the board. Cauley Stein's got 5 rebounds tonight. Wright dishes to Kerr. Shot clock at 6. From deep. We're at the end of the third, and we've still got a close one. Spurs lead by 3. And coming up as soon as we return from break, the fourth quarter gets underway. Well, this has been a great contest so far, and I imagine the fourth quarter could have even more action in store for us. Here's DeRozan. On the court for the Mavericks. DeJuan Wright is out there with Seth Curry. Then there's Cauley Stein. Then there's Michael Kidd-Gilchrist. And it's Kleba in at the 4-man position. DeRozan's shot is off. Mavericks trail by 3. Outside, Kidd-Gilchrist. Over Murray. Bank shot, no good. The Spurs shooting it up around 51%. They're getting good looks. Here's Lyles, and the dunk by Lyles.
Cutting his teeth in the Spurs system, Forbes has improved at keeping his eyes up and finding the open man.
Right, the pass to Cauley Stein. Outside, Kid Gilchrist. Now the pass to Curry. Dallas moving it around. Shot clock at 5. Kleba with the bucket.
And you don't want to allow too many of those short ones with the game right now in the balance.
Outside, DeRozan. Aldridge kicks to Lyles. Outside, DeRozan. Back to Lyles. He tries for 3. DeRozan's shot is off.
And you could tell he thought he had a little more space, but the defender was right there.
The ability to close out on perimeter shooters is so important in today's game.
Cauley Stein, a tremendous athlete and a dynamic finisher.
And the Spurs with possession. The Mavericks making the shot. Pass to DeRozan. And the rejection by Cauley Stein. Left side, Curry. Floats one up. Rebound, San Antonio. Lyles got 4 rebounds in this game. DeRozan against Kid Gilchrist. DeRozan, that's good. And the Spurs lead by 3.
The man is not timid. DeRozan's become one of the game's more prolific scorers, and he's showing it all tonight.
Dallas calls timeout.
And coaches looking to seize every advantage, maximize every possession.
Critical part of the game. You have to be flexible. You have to be able to adjust what you're doing.
Mavericks will go for a different look here. Porzingis is checked in for Cauley Stein. Dorian Finney-Smith comes in for Maxi Kleba. Hardaway's checked in for Kid Gilchrist. And Doncic is subbed in for Wright. All right, let's catch up with our sideline reporter, David Aldridge.
Hey, Kevin, I heard Rick Carlisle during that last break talking with the team. His concern was both their inconsistency and their amount of three-point shots. He said, let's move the ball for good shots. If you have an open 3, take it. Otherwise, let's attack the rim and put some pressure on these guys. Kevin?
Thank you, David.
And making his return from the ACL tear, DeJounte Murray, long, athletic, and young. He still has a very bright future.
And he makes the first. And Murray winning second team all-defense in 2018. And Greg, at that time, he was only 21.
And that's been his strong suit. If he can hit perimeter shots consistently, he can be a star.
And so Murray nails both of them.
I can't wait to see Murray reach his full potential. Reason why? Because he has a lot of it.
Doncic feeling it out. Hardaway. Look out! Here he comes!
That was amazing, and look at the elevation.
Right in the teeth of that defense, DeRozan explosive through contact.
Now, here's Curry. Passes it to Porzingis. Outside Curry. A 3 ball. San Antonio with the rebound. Murray's got 6 rebounds here tonight.
The struggle is real. He's been way off with his shot all evening long. putting consistent pressure on this defense. Just the threat of him out there makes this offense work.
Porzingis passes to Doncic. Again, the miss by the Mavericks.
Solid rebound there, and with the score like it is, that's an area where they can't afford to get lazy.
Pass to Wiles. He kicks to Forbes. Murray against Doncic. Shoots from the elbow. Murray, no good. Mavericks trail by 7.
They need a bucket in a big way here to regain some confidence.
Doubled by Murray. Doncic passes to Finney Smith, and the shot goes in.
Just a super unselfish guy. Doncic is all for getting his guys going. Enjoys setting the table.
Murray outside. And the basket is good. And the Spurs lead by 7.
That's a well-timed, well-coordinated play. Comes right off the pick for the lay-in.
Doncic outside. Right at the free throw line. Off the left rim and out. The Spurs have gone 5 for 9 from the field in the final quarter so far. To the wing right side. Murray dishes to Aldridge. Over Porzingis. Porzingis with the block.
And with his length, Porzingis can be very disruptive on D. Not easy to get the shot off over that huge frame. And wait to finish and cut into that lead a little bit.
But look at the basket guy still shaking. Here's Murray following the score by Dallas. And there's the pass to DeRozan. And they double up DeRozan. Knocks it loose. And he gets the bucket. DeRozan's got 10 points here in the second half.
And they're beginning to just flat out fall apart defensively right now. Especially on the interior.
Doncic passes to Porzingis. Back to Doncic. That's a hard away. Off target from 3-point range.
Definitely a situation you want to make sure you don't give him too good of a look.
Inside. And the dunk by DeRozan.
DeMar DeRozan, so athletic, rising up to slam it home. Great finish.
Doncic against Murray. Up top, Doncic. For Murray. And the shot is good. The Spurs lead has been cut to just 7 on the basket from Doncic.
You just love how reliable he is night in and night out. His offense is there.
Wiles kicks to Forbes. Pass to DeRozan. Here's Aldridge. Banked in off the glass. And the Spurs lead by 9.
LaMarcus does this well, getting into the mix and creating buckets off the offensive rebounds.
Dallas calls timeout. You gotta like what DeMar DeRozan has done in this game.
You know, he's been a one-man wrecking crew down low. His consistent scoring has dictated the pace of this game. We'll see if they decide to front him, bring a quick double, or maybe even both to try to slow him down.
And now we get the chance to present our Jordan Player of the Game, DeMar DeRozan.
And guys, this really has been his night. He's done a lot of things well, but his scoring really put him over the top. You can see how determined he's been every time he's gotten his hands on the ball. Great drive and also great focus offensively.
And at last, he gets a little redemption. You know, it's been several games since he's been at his best. He's really been having a tough time. Curry dishes to Doncic. And the shot goes in. Doncic has got 4 points now in the quarter.
And guys, the intelligence is evident. When the pick comes, Doncic often makes the right read.
San Antonio calls timeout. DeRozan passes to Aldridge, and Aldridge slams it in.
DeMar's a magnet for defensive attention. You see the overreaction leading to a wide open man.
Here's Doncic, and it's out of bounds. Last touch by Doncic.
This is what we talk about, valuing each possession, avoiding those kinds of mistakes.
They can burn some clock if they want to.
And get a little breather as well.
Hardaway against DeRozan. Switch. Out to White. Out of bounds. It'll be Mavericks ball.
Boy, if you're the coach, you hate to see that kind of miscommunication between your guys.
Here's Doncic. Side, Porzingis shoots over Lyle, and the shot is good. The Spurs lead has been cut to just 7 on the basket from Porzingis.
Nothing went right on that offensive possession except the result.
Now here is Aldridge, passes it to Lyle. Murray surveying the D, just 4 to shoot. Porzingis with the block, and they force the shot clock violation. Great D. Dorian Finney-Smith checked in for the Mavericks. Dallas has gotten off to an 0-for-2 start from downtown here in the fourth quarter. Here's Doncic. It counts. Oh, and that cuts the lead to just 5.
How about the poise from Doncic? Right there. He ups the ante when it's a critical possession here in the game.
Now, here's DeRozan over Hardaway. DeRozan, that's good.
He will credit them for maintaining that aggression, even being up this much.
They don't want to leave no chance for a comeback. Just focus on playing the right way.
Doncic, money!
Timeout.
Oh, and that cuts the lead to just 5.
Incredible. Doncic decides he wants to take over, and that's his personality. He comes up with the goods on that one.
San Antonio calls timeout. They're in front by 5. We've got 28 seconds left to play here in the fourth. And now we've got the intentional foul. Four seconds separating the shot and game clocks. And they go to the intentional foul. He drops the first one, and that increases their lead to six. And so both free throws are good, and it's a 7-point game.
Productive trip to the line extended their lead.
And the Mavericks call time here. They're trailing by seven. 23 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Guys, what's your take?
Licking their wounds. It hasn't come together for them tonight.
They are left picking up the remains of their game plan. Better luck next time.
There's Lee with the three. Rebounded by the Spurs. And they can just dribble the ball until the buzzer.
Yeah, they gotta be happy with the outcome.
Here's Mills. And so it's the Spurs with the win. Probably a little closer than they would have liked it, but a win nonetheless.
Yeah, but I really got a sense that the fans gave them that emotional boost that was needed down the stretch. This crowd, man, they were electric.
And a chance now to send it over to David Aldridge, standing by courtside. David.
Kevin, thank you. DeMar, this team is playing well together. How are you encouraging and fostering that sense of all of you being together and playing well?
We're just making everybody comfortable, making each and everybody on this team comfortable. If it's jump shots, if it's attacking the basket, you know, even if it's on the defensive end. You know, we're just giving each other confidence every time we practice.
And it sure looks like it out there tonight, DeMar. Thanks a lot. Kevin, back to you.
David, thank you as always. And that's going to do it tonight, folks, for our broadcast. For Greg Anthony, Steve Smith, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching. And we'll see you next time.